Welcome to Shanti Peaceful Mathematics. This video is based on radius of curvature at origin. So those who have not seen my previous video on the curvature, the detail about the curvature, what is the radius of curvature, all the things I have discussed in the I button. The video is already there. You can just go to the I button and watch that video and you will understand what you mean by radius of curvature of a curve at any given point, and then you come to this video lecture, so you will understand much more than this. So here I am going to prove that if x-axis is a tangent to a curve at the origin, then the rho, which we have denoted as a radius of curvature at point 0, 0 is rho at 0, 0 will be nothing but the limit of x tends to 0 x square upon 2y. Let us recall what is the formula for a radius of curvature. Formula for radius of curvature that we have denoted or in previous lecture we have derived for Cartesian, in Cartesian form, for any given point it is 1 plus y1 square, where y1 is the first derivative of y with respect to x, raised to 3 by 2 upon y2. So according to this, since the x-axis is a tangent to the curve, we definitely say that dy by dx at 0, 0 will be 0 due to the tangent is a x-axis. Okay, so that's why the first derivative is 0, 0. So we can say that y1 at 0, 0 is 0. Now let us observe what is y2. Now let us observe what will be this quantity. So if I substitute this value here, this will gives you 1 upon y2 at 0, 0. If I consider this is the radius of curvature at the point 0, 0, then it will be this. Now let us see what is this expression which we have given here. So we'll start with that limit x tends to 0 x square upon 2y. Since x is tending to 0 and y is also 0, and so this is 0 by 0 form, because it is the curve is passing through 0. So if your curve is y is equal to f of x, it has to be satisfied 0, 0 point, because the curve is passing through 0, and given that at 0 the x-axis is the tangent to the curve. So that's why this is 0 by 0 point. So it is indeterminate form. So by applying the L'Hospital rule, we can write this is 2x upon 2y1, that is the derivative of y with respect to x. Again, this is 0 by 0 form due to x is 0 and y1 is 0, as we have discussed earlier, the y1 first derivative at 0 is 0, so that is again 0 by 0 form. So this is again by applying the L'Hospital rule, this is 2 upon 2y2 at 0. This is also I have to write down y1 at 0. So this 2 will cancel out and you will have limit x tends to 0. This is 1 upon y2 at 0, 0 we have. Here I have used this notation, instead of that we have used this notation. Just stay with that notation. So what we have here, the rho is nothing but the 1 upon y2 at 0, 0. So that is, we have the radius of curvature at the point 0, 0. So that's the complete our proof. For that, if you want to calculate the radius of curvature at point 0, 0, if your tangent is a y-axis, then you will have this. Similarly, so if the tangent is the y-axis to the curve at origin, then the curvature can be calculated in this manner. That I am giving you as an homework. You can try for this yourself in the similar manner as we have discussed in the earlier. Now let us solve some examples based on this. So the question is, find a rho, that is the radius of curvature at the origin, for the curve y raised to 4 plus x cubed plus a x square plus y square minus a square y equal to 2. So the question is to find out the radius of curvature at the point 0,0, that is origin, to this curve. Maybe you have learned in your practical that a tracing of the curve, while learning the subject tracing of the curve, in that if you want to calculate the tangent at the origin, the tangent at the origin is nothing but the lowest degree term at 0. So if you can find out the tangent at origin is by equating the lowest degree term equal to 0. So here in this expression, the lowest degree term is a square y. So that's why a square y is equal to 0. And the a square is never 0. So that's why it is y equal to 0. Here given that a is positive, if I consider. So that means the y equal to 0 is the tangent to the curve. That means I can say that the x-axis is the tangent at the origin. So let us write down that. So therefore, x-axis is the tangent at origin to the curve. And therefore, by the formula that we have derived just now, the radius of curvature at the point 0, 0 you can have, that is limit x tends to 0, x square upon 2y. Now we need to have what is x square upon 2y is a rho, and we have expression given is y raised to 4 plus x cube plus a x square plus y square minus is y equal to 0. So I am just dividing this equation by y, and we will write down this into this expression. So that is, you will have y cube plus x into x square by y. If I divide by y and I split this x cube as x into x square, plus a square by y is there, plus y minus a square equal to 0 you will have. Now by taking limit x tends to 0, we know that y is also tending to 0 because the curve is passing through 0 point or origin. So that's why you will have, this is 0, the first x is there, x is also 0, then you will have this x square by y. Due to this limit x tends to 0, this is nothing but the rho at 0, that is the radius of curvature, into a, this is also rho at 0, plus 0 you will have here because the curve is passing through origin, and minus a square is there. So finally, if you simplify this, you will have rho equal to a by 2 because this a square is there and this a divide to that. That's why you will have a by 2, and that is your radius of curvature at the point 0, 0. So in that manner, if you are to calculate the radius of curvature for any curve, if the tangent is x-axis, then you will calculate in that manner, and if the tangent is y-axis, then also you have a formula for that. Let's solve one more example here, but this is not same as the previous one. Let us see that example. Find rho at the origin for the curve y minus x is equal to x square plus 2xy plus y square. Now, as I already told you that if you want to calculate the tangent at origin, because first of all this curve is passing through origin, and if you want to calculate the tangent at origin is can be get by equating a lowest degree term equal to 0. So the lowest degree term in this will be 1, that is y minus x equal to 0. That will imply x is equal to y is the tangent. So here your tangent is not x-axis or y-axis, so you cannot use the previous formula. But there is another technique to deal with this one. By Taylor's expansion, we can able to calculate what is the radius of curvature for this curve. So we know that if y is a function, then the Taylor's expansion for that, it is y0 plus y dash 0 into x plus y double dash 0 into x square by 2 factorial, and so on. This is the expression we have. Since this curve is passing through 0, y0 is 0, and so you will have 0 plus y dash at 0 plus into x plus y double dash into x square by 2, and so on. And I will substitute this value of y into this expression, and let us see what we'll have. Let us write down first of all that expression again here. That is y minus x is equal to x square plus 2xy plus y square. And I am putting that expression in the previous page we have calculated. That is y dash of 0 into x plus y double dash of 0 into x square by 2 up to so on plus x square as it is. Minus x is already here, so that is minus x plus x square as it is plus 2x is there. Then again we'll have this y dash 0 into x plus y double dash 0 into x square by 2 plus so on plus y square is there, so that's why it is y dash of 0 x plus y double dash of 0 into x square by 2 factorial or 2 whole square. Now I'm comparing a coefficient of x and x square both sides. So equating coefficient of x and x square we have. So first of all you just see that this is the square. So maximum power, if this is the square in this term, the maximum power in this term will be x square. And then, so let us see what is the x term, how many x terms are there. Now, since this 2x is multiplying to this, here is the maximum power is also x square. So the only term which having the x term is this and this. On this side there is no term of x is there. So that's why y dash 0 minus 1, because that is the coefficient of x, equal to 0, because on this side there is no x term. So that means we'll have the y dash at 0 will be 1. And now equating the coefficient of x square. So on this side the coefficient of x square is y double dash 0 by 2. And on the other side we have the coefficient is here, it is 1 plus when you multiply this x to this one, then it is 2y dash will be there. And when you multiply this x to this x square, then it will have a x cube term, so that will not consider. When you do the square of this quantity, the first things you will get is y dash square into x square, so that is the lowest degree term in that term, in this term. So that's why you will have the coefficient is y dash square whole square. And from this y dash 0 is 1, so that's why you will have now y double dash 0, which will be 2 times 1 plus 2 into 1 plus 1. So finally you will have it is 8. And now we have the formula for radius of curvature. The radius of curvature at origin we can write down as 1 plus y1 square, y1 at 0 square raised to 3 by 2 upon y2 at 0. But y1 at 0 in the previous page we have calculated 1, and y2 at 0 it is 8. So that's why we have this is 1 plus 1 raised to 3 by 2 upon 8. So that is 2 raised to 3 by 2 upon 2 raised to 3. So that will give you 2 into square root of 2. So that is the radius of curvature at the 0, 0 we have. So in this video lecture, we have discussed that how to calculate the radius of curvature at the origin in the two different manner. So one of them is the tangent is the x-axis or y-axis, then you will calculate by the formula that limit x square upon y as x tends to 0. This is gives you radius of curvature at 0, 0. And the another way is by using the Taylor series expansion. So that's it for this video. If you like this video, please press the like button. If you have any comment, suggestion or question, please drop down in the comment box below. See you in the next video. Till then, bye-bye. Sayonara.